It's been said that you play baseball, play football, or play basketball. You don't play fighting. To put yourself on the line against an opponent trained to defeat you is not something for the weak-minded. Because while mastering all combat sports disciplines is necessary to compete, to succeed, a fighter must have the heart and determination to walk through fire in search of victory. Tonight, the journey begins. Far from the bright lights of Las Vegas or New York City, but as the saying goes, when the octagon door shuts, a fight's a fight.
Hey, I'm UFC President Dana White, and we're always looking for up-and-coming talent to sign. Back in the day, I used to scout the world looking for new talent, but I haven't done that in years. I'm looking for the next Ronda Rousey, the next Robbie Lawler, the next Conor McGregor. I'm looking for future champions, and I'm willing to go to any show, anywhere in the world to find them. Super excited about the talent on tonight's card. A lot of tough fighters. Let's see who really wants their shot at the UFC.
This should be interesting. Here we go.
The rock and sock and throw box. Wow.
That was nasty. Come on.
Look at the recovery. Look at the recovery. Look at this.
Yeah.
You notice when it's a good mount, like a BJ 10 mount, when those feet are close together and the guy cannot get his leg to the floor. Come on, beat a bully. Beat a bully, man. Nice. This is good. Look at the transitions. That's slick. You even see that now? Did you even see it? You can see the skill. Look at this!
Yeah.
this is nice. Here we go, here we go.
I didn't see this coming.
Look at this. Look, over the top. Oh!
Potential. We're going to do this. We're going to give her a shot in the UFC.
Hey everyone, I'm Megan O'Leary and this is your UFC Minute. The UFC returns this weekend with a fresh face who is destined to make headlines.
When UFC president Dana White went looking for a fight, he was hoping that he would end up with a future UFC star. And those are the expectations after he signed a regional champion who has dominated the local women's strawweight circuit en route to her octagon debut this weekend.
That's it for today. Stay tuned for your next UFC Minute, and I'll see you at the fights.
All right, coming up next, it's a UFC women's strawweight division matchup. Well, with much fanfare, Joe Rogan, here she is. She was discovered on Dana White looking for a fight. And man, did she come through in a high-pressure spot that night. Tonight, though, decidedly more pressure. UFC Octagon for the first time, and everything that accompanies the UFC experience. You know about the famed UFC jitters. Not a factor for every newcomer. She doesn't look wide-eyed right now. But if there is an adrenaline dump, how does she deal with that and remain in the fight?
This girl is an outstanding striker. She definitely wants to keep this fight on the feet. She has very good takedown defense as well, good hands, very good kicks, elbows, knees, and punches, a full arsenal of striking techniques.
Well, when you watch film on her, hard to see anything in terms of weaknesses, Joe. She is a true mixed martial artist. Plus skills in all areas. Really not going to jump off the page in any one discipline, but she has proven to be a handful for just about anybody and just about everywhere the fight goes. With her skill set, she is comfortable anywhere inside that octagon.
This girl is a really well-rounded fighter, a full and complete mixed martial artist with an arsenal of techniques from Muay Thai, kickboxing, jiu-jitsu, judo, wrestling, boxing. She can really do it all. So very unpredictable in that regard and very comfortable no matter where the fight goes.
Our tale of the day for this strawweight fight. So 3 years the gap in age between these two fighters with similar height and the same reach. Here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is three rounds in the UFC strawweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, making her UFC debut here tonight. She stands 5 feet 4 inches tall, weighing in at 115 pounds, fighting out of Eva Beach, Hawaii, Kailin Curran. And now introducing her opponent, fighting out of the red corner, a Muay Thai kickboxer and jiu-jitsu fighter holding a professional record of 6 wins, 4 losses. She stands 5 feet 6 inches tall, weighing in at 114 pounds. Fighting out of Las Vegas, Nevada, Merciless! And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the octagon is Dan Mergliotta.
Dan Mergliotta, your referee.
You ready? You ready?
Well, a huge night of UFC action coming your way. It all begins right now as we start up with this first fight from United Center in Chicago, Illinois. All right, so here she is as we get ready to go for round one, the much-hyped UFC debut for this young woman. She won her last fight, many of you saw it, in front of Dana White and Matt Serra on Looking for a Fight. Now we'll see if her game translates to the big show. No easy outs in this division. We'll see if she can get off to a good start tonight. Oh, nice jab by Kailin Curran. All right, first round is underway, and her opponent has got to be mindful of the different kicks in her arsenal, Joe. She'll attack the leg, she'll go to the body. Head kicks part of her arsenal as well. Let's see if the defense has anything for her here in the early going. That punch will work right through the guard. Couple of chins here being tested early. And the kick lands. Mixes it up nicely in terms of staying heavy and also staying active. She blocked the punch.
Clean punch.
She's going back to the jab.
Slightly deflected.
Going from orthodox to southpaw here, Joe. Oh, that punch will count. Landed flush. And there's that inside leg kick, Joe. Just out of range with that right hand.
That one hurt.
The kick is there to the body. Trying to establish that jab once again.
Good exchanges from both fighters.
Oh, there, got a few shots through. Oh! Wow! This could be it right here.
Whoa! Oh!
She's out!
And that's gonna do it!
Ruthless ground and pound for the victory.
Yes, Joe, just outstanding ground and pound for her to finish her opponent tonight. She was throwing one big shot after the next, not just looking to score, but actually looking to end the fight.
And here's the end. Let's take a look at that again. Look at this. I mean, just stiff.
And there she is after the massive knockout. That is one they will be talking about for quite some time. All right, we now go inside the octagon. Bruce Buffer has the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Mergliotta is going to stop this contest at 3 minutes, 34 seconds of the very first round. Declaring the winner by knockout, Kailin Curran.
So a nice way to win the UFC debut, and the UFC jitters, feigned as they may be, not a factor for her here tonight as she starts to celebrate with her coaches. Congratulations to the UFC newcomer on the big W in her UFC debut. All right, coming up next, it's a UFC women's strawweight division matchup. Well, it's nice to see her relishing the moment here tonight, but as soon as that octagon door closes, the smile goes away and the hands and kicks keep on coming. Gotta think she's interested in keeping this fight standing tonight. Has the decided advantage on the feet. No doubt she'll try to put on a striking clinic in front of the masses here tonight.
This girl is an outstanding striker. She definitely wants to keep this fight on the feet. She has very good takedown defense as well. Good hands, very good kicks, elbows, knees, and punches. A full arsenal of striking techniques.
All right, here she is, ladies and gentlemen, making her way to the octagon. So the wait is nearly over for this rivalry matchup here tonight. These fighters do not like each other. That is not breaking news. If you'd followed this fight during fight week, the bad blood getting up in each other's faces at the weigh-in. We'll see who emerges in this rivalry matchup here tonight.
This girl is an excellent striker. Very fast hands, excellent Muay Thai, good boxing, very good takedown defense, and she is an aggressive pressure fighter.
For this strawweight fight. So 2 years, the gap in age, with the same height and some differences in reach. And now to get us started, here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is three rounds in the UFC strawweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This woman is a kickboxer, holding a professional record of 6 wins, 6 losses. She stands 5'4" tall, weighing in at 114 pounds, the Buzzsaw. And now introducing her opponent, fighting out of the red corner. This woman is a kickboxer, holding a professional record of 6 wins, 1 loss. She stands 5'4" tall, weighing in at 115 pounds, fighting out of Eva Beach, Hawaii, Kailin Curran. And when the action begins, our referee in charge, Eve Levine.
The veteran Eve Levine draws the assignment here.
Ready?
We are underway.
Beautiful strike here to end the fight early in the first.
Yeah, Joe, how about the knockout there? Beautiful technique to land the fight-ending shot. And again, we're a broken record when it comes to this, but sometimes when you catch a fighter cold, maybe before she's had a chance to get herself into the fight, that strike can have a bigger effect. It certainly did here tonight.
Here it is again from another angle. And let's see that again.
Boom. Well, that's a knockout they'll be talking about for quite some time. What a moment for this fighter here tonight. Bruce Buffer now with the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Eve Levine has called a stop to this contest at 10 seconds of the very first round, declaring the winner by knockout, Kailin Curran.
So the rivalry matchup goes her way here tonight. She can finally exhale. You see her celebrating with her coaches and her teammates. She wanted this one in the worst way, and she gets it. Nice way to take advantage of the spotlight here tonight.
The most intoxicating word in the world of mixed martial arts is potential. Every fighter starts out with a clean slate and lofty dreams. But fight by fight, the talent pool shrinks. And only a select few will rise to the top in the UFC. You've done your part so far, growing your fan following while earning the respect of your peers in the octagon, stamping yourself as a fighter on the fast track to a championship. But even now, it's clear that this taste of success will either push you to greater heights or send you tumbling, making your winning streak a distant memory. Which path will you choose?
I'm Magna Levy, and this is your UFC Minute. As a fighter's wins begin to add up, the pressure to maintain momentum becomes a major factor. Every fighter who competes in the octagon will tell you that she will take a win by any means possible. But as one of the UFC's top strikers, this women's strawweight star is taking the judges out of the equation, as she has used fists and feet to finish each of her opponents during her winning streak by way of spectacular knockout. That's it for today. Stay tuned for your next UFC Minute, and I'll see you at the fights.
To become a legend in the UFC, a fighter needs someone to push her to be great. McGregor had Diaz, Jones had Cormier, and Silva had Sonnen. Each series didn't just pit the best against the best, but it matched up rivals that had personal scores to settle. And when the octagon door shut, the bad blood reached a boiling point. Who will be the one to step up and put this feud to rest, or give up bragging rights once and for all?
It is a women's 115-pound matchup between Juliana Jutai Lima and Kailin Curran. All right, so here she is making her way to the octagon, and you gotta think she'll have to bottle the emotions here tonight. This is not just another fight. Despite what she has said during fight week, this is a rivalry matchup. These fighters do not like each other. They might not even bury the gauntlet after the fight. There is legitimate bad blood here. Let's see which woman rises above it and gets her hand raised here tonight.
This woman has frightening knockout power. Absolutely thunderous power behind both her punches and her kicks. She is a real threat to knock anyone out in this division.
So here is Juliana Jutai Lima training out of Gracie Baja, Texas, under the unheralded Vinicius Draculino Magalhães. A lot of sparring and takedown defense in recent training camps. There's no denying the Muay Thai skills. Great ground and pound, good takedowns as well. Her knees will be on display tonight. A lot of different striking skills brought to the table by Juliana Jutai Lima.
This girl is a Muay Thai expert. Very, very high level kickboxing skills with a full arsenal of striking techniques. She is deadly on the feet.
Our tale of the tape for this strawweight fight. Lima is 9 years the elder. The rest of the numbers are nearly identical. And now for the particulars, here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is 3 rounds in the UFC strawweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This woman is a kickboxer holding a professional record of 10 wins, 1 loss. She stands 5'4" tall, weighing in at 115 pounds, fighting out of Iwa Beach, Hawaii, Kailin Curran. And now introducing her opponent, fighting out of the red corner, a Muay Thai kickboxer holding a professional record of 9 wins, 6 losses. She stands 5'5" tall, weighing in at 115 pounds, fighting out of Belo Horizonte, Brazil, Juliana.
The veteran Herb Dean draws the assignment here.
Ready.
All right, we are underway here at Juness Arena in Rio de Janeiro, Brazil. All right, so here we go with round one of this rivalry matchup between two of the best women in this division. And man, did they not like each other. It's always an interesting backdrop to a UFC fight. Let's see who can bottle the emotions and let their skills take over here tonight. Nice punch by Lee.
They have started this fight off with a brawl.
All right, so here we go. Round one is underway. And you know, Joe, she's got some of the most powerful kicks in this division. Let's see if she can find the range early here tonight. Nice punch by Lima. Oh, no way, spinning back fist. Landing a good series of strikes here. Curran gets caught with that punch. Don't be afraid to get that head off the center line.
Oh, powerful right leg kick.
All right, so there's that patented lead leg kick. She's gonna attack that limb all night long. That's what she said during fight week.
Oh, double jab.
Nice jab there by Kailin Curran. Lima gets tagged by the head kick there. Not sure how many more of those she can absorb if she wants to stay in this fight. Oh, that kick is good by Kailin Curran. Bleeding from her cheek now, Joe. Damage done. Oh, nice jab to the head there by Curran.
Wow, what a back and forth exchange. Really threw a lot of power into that uppercut, but missed. Oh, 1-2.
Over 2 minutes to go in what has been a furious round one. Wind it up on the right there to no avail.
Dropping down, looking for a single.
Oh, she gets the single leg takedown here, Joe. That's her best shot. Connects there with the punch.
She establishes full mount.
Big punch from the top.
Effective punch there by Kailin Curran. The ground strikes continue to pile up.
She's working from half guard.
Well, she's able to get back up here, but man, look how wobbly she is. Wow. Southpaw stance to orthodox now. Just misses there with the left.
Oh, beautiful uppercut.
Wow!
This could be it right here. 30 seconds to go. That's a big hook. Body kick, look at that.
Oh, nice flying knee attempt there.
Oh! Horns out for the end of round one. Oh, saved by the bell there. There's the horn, end of the round. Thankfully, she will live to see another round. So back to the stool. She only has 60 seconds here to recover. We'll see if her corner physically and mentally can keep her in this fight. What a seminal moment there at the end of the round.
Let's see it one more time.
The OG Ariane Celeste in the building with us tonight.
Ready to fight? Ready.
All right, round two.
Excellent feint with the kick.
Oh, beautiful leg kick by her there. Can't take too many of those. Curran's head kick is blocked. No damage there. Oh!
Just nicely, but in half guard now. Oh, beautiful right hand. She moves to half guard. Beautiful body shot there, too. Tries to pass, but can't. Excellent movement here on the ground. She's now working from full guard.
Well, she's up, but she looks hurt. Well, Joe, I know she's got a lot of faith in her chin, but at what cost? She has shown an increased susceptibility to head kicks by moving right into her opponent's range. That one landed. It landed flush. Let's see if she can adjust.
Huge uppercut misses.
Nice.
Switching stances here. Now she lands the knee. How about that chin? Well, that left hand has been there for her tonight. Not on that attempt.
Oh! This could be it. Big shots. Look at this. Takedown.
Effective punch there by Kailin Curran.
It appears the cut on her face is getting worse.
Trying to stay heavy here as best she can.
Good control here.
Under 2 minutes to go.
Lands a good shot from the bottom. Excellent movement and transitions here on the ground. Staying busy.
Trying to stay heavy here as best she can.
Side control again. Excellent movement on the ground here. Constantly moving, constantly staying busy. Now establish side control again.
Oh, nice punch there by Curran. Well, she's able to get up again here, Joe, but look at her, visibly hurt. Going for the single leg now. Takedown attempt late in the round, and she gets it. Connects with the punch there. The ground strikes starting to pile up.
Back up.
Here's the kick blocked by Lima. Two rounds in the books.
Ah! Stop! Your kickboxing is really impressive. She's lost out there against you. Keep that.
Here's a vicious kick that results in a knockdown. Let's take a look at that again. And let's see if we can get a better look at that from another angle.
Good to have Brazil's Jenny Andrade in the building here.
Ready to fight? Ready.
Third round underway. Oh, she landed another strike to the body there. Very smart to work that body late in the fight when her opponent is fatigued. You didn't see a lot of that from her earlier in the fight. She is certainly getting after it now.
Good shot. Excellent movement here on the ground. Full back mount here. Oh, this is nasty. Trying to spin to the back. Excellent movement and transitions here on the ground. Staying busy. Nice shot to the head.
Trying to finish this fight.
Back to half guard. Postures up.
Oh, strong punch there by Kailin Curran. Just over 3 minutes to go in our third and final round.
Beautiful sweep. Into half guard again.
Back to the feet now. Oh, she's really starting to put together some significant body shots here. Attacking both sides now.
Perfectly placed flying knee.
Oh, for sure, Joe. A devastating knee employed by her to get the stoppage win here tonight. It doesn't always look like the most significant strike in the world, but she got that knee to the target, and her opponent didn't know what's coming. So her bankroll might be $50,000 fatter at the end of the night. A huge performance for her to get the knee knockout here tonight.
Let's see it from a different angle here. Massive power and torque behind that knee, and as soon as it lands, that is a wrap. Check out this angle here. I mean, just stiff.
And there she is after the huge knockout victory here tonight. What a moment for this young fighter. You gotta feel pretty good for her, Joe. Here now, Bruce Buffer with the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean has called a stop to this contest at 2 minutes, 24 seconds of the third round. Declared the winner by knockout, Kailin Curran.
So the rivalry matchup goes her way here tonight. She can finally exhale. You see her celebrating with her coaches and her teammates. She wanted this one in the worst way, and she gets it. Nice way to take advantage of the spotlight here tonight. It is a women's 115-pound matchup between Felice Herring and Kailin Curran. Well, it's nice to see her relishing the moment here tonight, but as soon as that octagon door closes, the smile goes away and the hands and kicks keep on coming. Gotta think she's interested in keeping this fight standing tonight. Has the decided advantage on the feet. No doubt she'll try to put on a striking clinic in front of the masses here tonight.
This girl is a true takedown expert. She has a full arsenal of takedown techniques, and it is her specialty. She is so good at closing the distance and utilizing spectacular takedowns to bring her opponent to the mat.
So here is the perennial strawweight contender, Felice Herring. She started kickboxing essentially right out of high school in 2003 and never looked back. Turned pro in mixed martial arts in 2009, purple belt in Brazilian jiu-jitsu, has an outstanding submission game, but is known primarily as a Muay Thai practitioner, a kickboxing fighter who sets a furious pace and has the stamina to stay with it. Felice Herring, fighting as always in the memory of her late brother, trying to get it done here tonight.
This girl has off the charts cardio. It is one of her biggest assets and one of the things that she pushes the hardest on. She knows that most fighters can't keep up with her, so she drags them into a race that they simply can't win. It's one of her strongest assets, and she is extremely confident in utilizing it.
Our tale of the tape for this strawweight fight. So a more than 5-year gap between these two fighters when it comes to the age, and they have the same height and reach. All right, now for the official introductions, we go inside the octagon where we find Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the octagon, Dan Smirgliotta. And now, this is the moment you've all been waiting for. Live from the MGM Grand Garden Arena in Las Vegas,
this woman is a kickboxer holding a professional record of 12 wins, 1 loss. She stands 5'4" tall, weighing in at 115 pounds. Fighting out of Iba Beach, Hawaii, Kailin Curran. And now introducing her opponent, fighting out of the red corner. This woman is a mixed martial artist holding a professional record of 19 wins, 9 losses. She stands 5'4" tall, weighing in at 115 pounds, fighting out of Crystal Lake, Illinois, Felice Lilbulgari.
All right, commit the rules in the locker room. I want you to obey my commands at all times, protect yourself at all times. Want a nice, clean, safe fight. Touch gloves, back your corners, come out fighting.
They touch him up, man. We are underway.
You ready? You ready?
All right, ready for live action here at the MGM Grand Garden Arena here in the fight capital of the world. Well, you can expect a high volume of output in round one from Felice Herrick. She is as conditioned as any strawweight on the roster. Prevailing wisdom is if we hit a second or third round, she'll be the fresher party. She doesn't have to conserve her gas tank. Felice Herrick getting aggressive here early. Oh, landed that kick to the leg. Nicely done here in the early going with the takedown. All right, first round is underway, and you better watch out for the overhand punches when you're fighting an opponent of this caliber. It really has become a patented punch of hers and something that a lot of opponents know is coming but still can't account for. Let's see how long it takes her to find her range here tonight. Oh, she connected flush. Continuing to stay busy here on the ground. Well, she's got a good jab, missed with it there.
That one hurt.
Oh, she moved right into that head kick, Joe. Not a good look for her there at all. I'm not sure how many more of those she can take, quite frankly. She's got to figure some things out here defensively. She's going back to that patented straight right hand, unable to connect. Curran gets tagged by the head kick there. Not sure how many more of those she can absorb if she wants to stay in this fight.
Straight right. Missed that shot.
Oh, another head kick lands for her there, Joe. And one more, and this fight could be over. It's amazing what a chin she has. I'm just not sure how many more she can take.
Oh!
Curran gets caught with that punch. Gotta shore up the defense here.
Really missed with that right hand.
Working on a single leg here.
Oh! Trying to spin to the back. And they clinch here.
Oh, now the hook and the clinch by Herrick.
Double underhooks.
Oh, she planted her on the canvas yet again. So another takedown. She's already landed several. And now they're really starting to pile up here, Joe. And I like the way she's shooting, too. Mixing up the single legs and the double legs, not telegraphing her shots. She's one of the better wrestlers in this division. And she is showing you all of that game here tonight.
Couldn't agree with you more. In half guard.
Nice punch by Harry.
Oh, reversal.
Left punch is good. Trying to stay heavy here as best she can.
Looks like she's got an armbar here. Throws the other leg over the face. It looks like she's got that armbar locked in tight.
Round two straight ahead. Oh, saved by the bell. Round over. And the finish came just in time. Thought maybe she might tap there, but you know how tough she is. So the submission attempt right at the end of the round. Saved by the bell. Back to the stools they go. We'll see if she can recover in time for this next round.
Let's take a look at it from a different angle.
Letting her sit on top of you. We can't have that. We came to fight, not to just lay there. I need you to look for your underhooks. Post it.
Brittany Palmer is in the building. Harry gets absolutely pelted by that head kick. Splits the guard and connects there.
Oh, big kick! Oh!
Trying to establish that jab once again.
There's a single attempt.
And another takedown. Scored a lot of points with these. Now the opponent is getting up quickly, but no doubt these takedowns are starting to add up.
Beautiful right hand. Good punch. Front kick to the body.
She's got her up against the cage.
And they separate. Oh! It appears she has a cut on her eyebrow. Oh! This could be it right here.
Under 3 minutes now to go in the round. Well, overall, her striking has been sharp tonight. She has landed some good shots, but more often than not, Joe, she's been one and done. As yet, unable to string together significant combinations. And it's gonna take a good combination to really put her opponent in harm's way. Let's see how she chooses to attack here. Just over 2 minutes now to go in round two. Working on a choke here, potentially.
She's got it locked.
Consistently finding a home for that left punch.
Big punch from the top.
Less than a minute to go in the round.
Look at that. Nice. Some good punches from the top here.
Seconds to go in round two.
Landing some good punches from this position. In half guard. That's a big shot right there. Excellent movement and transitions here on the ground. Staying busy.
All right, that's the end of round number two.
And here we see some beautiful submission offense here. Let's check it out from a different angle. Beautiful submission attempt. It looks good, but can't get it.
Deep breath. All right, listen. Now, I want you to stay relaxed.
Ariane Celeste in the building.
You ready?
Third round underway. Effective punch there by Curran.
Oh!
Nice. Good job landing that series of punches here.
Excellent movement on the ground here. Constantly moving, constantly staying busy. Definitely attacking an arm triangle here.
Nicely done.
Excellent movement here on the ground. Secures north-south position.
Switching stances here.
Harry gets in the clinch here. Now let's see how she proceeds. Oh, she pummels Joe. Now she's got double underhooks. Take down there by Harry. Curran's lower jaw now, Joe, starting to show some signs of swelling.
Big body punch.
Under 3 minutes remain in round three.
Trying to stay heavy here as best she can.
Nice punch there by Harris. We have crossed the midpoint of this one. While working pretty effectively from the top here, nice ground and pound by Harris. Trying to get that arm underneath the chin.
She's got that choke tight. She escaped the choke.
Seconds now to go in the round.
Moves in a north-south. Excellent movement and transitions here on the ground. Staying busy.
Making all these shots count. All right, less than a minute here to go now in round three. All right, so look for her to set up another takedown attempt here. She hasn't telegraphed her shots in tonight. She's been very good in terms of the timing on her entries. Let's see if she goes for another takedown.
Nice left hand into half guard again. Landed some big punches from this position.
15 seconds.
Trying to take the back here.
That's three rounds in the can. We're headed to the championship rounds.
All right, you're doing great, okay? I want more of the same. You are controlling the entire fight. Stay sharp.
Let's take a look at some of the action from that round. And here we see some beautiful submission offense here. And there's another excellent attempt at the submission, but can't quite finish it. Let's see it one more time. Incredible highlights in that round.
Ariane Celeste doing her thing as usual.
You ready?
Fourth round now, fight scheduled for 5 5-minute rounds. She's able to avoid the clinch. Well, that left hand has been there for her tonight, not on that attack.
He tries to pass here, but gets shut down.
Southpaw stance to orthodox now. Curran's lower jaw is extremely swollen now.
And they disengage from the clinch.
Oh, shot to the body connects there. Beautifully placed right underneath the elbow. She didn't really throw a lot of body shots overall in the fight, but in the latter stages, smart to work the body.
we go, north-south position.
She's now working from side control. Inside control, tying up that arm, looking for the Kimura. That arm looks locked up tight. She got her arm out.
Good punch.
2 minutes now to go. Well, this is a tough fighter to buck off. Very good pressure and work here by Herrick.
Side control again.
Effective punch there by Herrick.
Left
hand there.
Big hammer fist. Oh, that's it.
That'll do it.
Beautiful knockout. Nasty ground and pound for the win.
Yeah, Joe, that's about as good as it gets in terms of the ground and pound in modern-day mixed martial arts. She wasn't stalling. She wasn't trying to score points. She was trying to finish the fight. Certainly, you can say mission accomplished on that front as she gets the big TKO victory here in this round.
Here's a different angle on it. And here we see it one more time. Look at the timing in this shot. Bam! Out cold.
And there she is after the huge knockout here tonight. What a moment for this fighter. You can't help but feel good for her here tonight. We send it in there now to Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Mariano's called a stop to this contest at 3 minutes, 57 seconds of round number 4. Declaring the winner by knockout, Felice Wilbuhan-Harris.
Well, there are few greater highs in all of professional sports than to have your hand raised inside that octagon, but she took it a step further tonight. Massive knockout victory. No TKO here. This was a flush KO. She's probably getting some bonus money. One thing I can guarantee you, she is getting a massive, high-profile opportunity next. All right, coming up next, yes, a women's strawweight matchup between Joanne Calderwood and Kailin Curran. Well, here she is, really as accomplished a striker as there is in this division. She told us, definitely interested in keeping this fight standing tonight. Have to lean on the takedown defense. I'm not afraid to sprawl, because if I can keep this fight upright, that is where my biggest advantage in the fight is. Really, really technical, sound, powerful, fast striker. She looks to put on a show tonight.
This girl has ridiculously impressive lightning fast hand speed. It is one of her best qualities and one of the most terrifying things that you could face inside the octagon. When someone is faster than you, it is such a huge advantage.
Well, it's nice to see her relishing the moment here tonight, but as soon as that octagon door closes, the smile goes away and the hands and kicks keep on coming. Gotta think she's interested in keeping this fight standing tonight. Has the decided advantage on the feet. No doubt she'll try to put on a striking clinic in front of the masses here tonight.
This girl has outstanding defense and very good blocking technique. It's so difficult to hit her cleanly. It is a big advantage for her, and she has so much confidence in her defense because of that.
Our tale of the tape for this strawweight fight. 4 years, the difference in age between these two fighters, with similar height and the same reach. All right, now for the introductions, here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is 3 rounds in the UFC strawweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, a kickboxer holding a professional record of 12 wins, 2 losses. She stands 5 feet 4 inches tall, weighing in at 115 pounds, fighting out of Eva Beach, Hawaii, Kailin Curran. This woman is a Muay Thai kickboxer, holding a professional record of 15 wins, 3 losses. She stands 5 feet 6 inches tall, weighing in at 115 pounds, fighting out of Glasgow, Scotland, Joanna Calderwood. And when the action begins, our referee in charge, Eve Levine.
The veteran Eve Levine draws the assignment here.
You ready?
All right, we are underway here at the famed Madison Square Garden right in New York City. Calderwood, a multi-time champion in Muay Thai in Europe, 19-2 as a pro kickboxer.
Oh!
Whiffs on the elbow. All right, first round is underway, and you better watch out for the overhand punches when you're fighting an opponent of this caliber. It really has become a patented punch of hers, and something that a lot of opponents know is coming, but still can't account for. Let's see how long it takes her to find her range here tonight.
Welcome to the jungle.
Just missing on the high kick there. Oh, clipped her with the jab. Able to check the high kick.
Oh!
Curran gets caught with that punch. Got to shore up the defense here.
Oh! This could be it! Misses a huge hook to the head.
Under 3 minutes now to go in round one.
Really swung for the fences with that hook, but misses.
JoJo's starting to wear it a little bit. Oh, huge block for her, Joe.
Oh!
Splits the guard and connects there.
Tries a big hook to the head, but misses.
Oh, she landed that kick.
This could be it right here. Oh! Whoa, head kick. She might try to finish this fight here. Oh, very nice.
90 seconds to go in round one.
Again with a solid kick to the body.
Oh, she lands another strike to the body, Joe. She's really starting to connect on a lot of strikes to the body. How about that shin?
Lands a hard kick. Big power in those kicks.
The left hook hits home. Huge shots there. Now goes in and secures the takedown.
Reversal. Very nice.
Effective punch there by Curran.
Excellent movement here on the ground. In half guard.
Calderwood gets caught with that punch.
She's now in full guard. Good control, postures up.
Round two next.
Hey, stop!
She touched you. No big deal. That'll heal. What won't heal is a loss. I need you to get back up off this stool.
Let's see some of the action here. And there's the kick to the body. And here's a perfectly placed kick that really does damage.
Brittany Palmer here doing her thing as usual. Second round underway.
Oh, jumping knee! Attempts a big hook to the head, but misses.
Oh, that'll ring your bell. Head kick.
Body kick, look at that.
She's starting to put together some significant body work here, and these are going to take their toll as this fight goes on. And the kick lands for her there.
Excellent combination.
Curran's leg appears to be hurt here, Joe. That is an obvious win.
Oh! This could be it! Look at this! Takedown!
Nice sweep right into side control.
Curran gets hit by that leg kick, so maybe that one gets her attention. Another takedown attempt here. Curran gets the single leg takedown. Nicely done there. Calderwood's strike attempt there is blocked.
Misses a huge hook to the head.
Huge right hand! Big right hand!
This could be it right here. Good right hand.
Big body shot.
To the body.
Let's go. We got a scramble here.
Just over 2 minutes to go in the round.
Side control. She's working from half guard.
Trying to establish that jab. Well, she has certainly picked up the pace here in round two and starting to find herself in the pocket a little bit. She was a little bit hesitant in round one. No hesitancy whatsoever here in round two. She has clearly found her rhythm and range.
She's in half guard now. Postures up. She moves to half guard.
Oh, pretty good work from the bottom here, Joe, as she tags her with that punch.
Into half guard again. Very nicely timed sweep, and now she's in half guard.
Effective punch there by Calderwood.
Vicious ground and pound from half guard. And now she's working from side control. It appears that cut is getting worse. Trying to spin to the back.
Oh, so the round is over, but not before she got absolutely starched by that huge shot just before the final horn. So she goes back to the stool now. We'll see the extent to which she can recover. As many of you know, 60 seconds, not a lot of time.
And let's check it out from a different angle.
Relax, breathe. All right, here's some water. Now listen, I want you to stay sharp. Don't get suckered into that crap. I want you to get out.
Ariane Celeste in the building as usual.
You ready? You ready?
All right, 5 minutes to decide this one.
Oh! This could be it.
That goes in and secures the takedown.
Gets in a full guard here. Lands a good shot from the bottom. She's now in half guard again. Back to full guard.
Curran's lower jaw is just nasty at this point. Really swollen in that area now. Total strikes. Another shot. Takedown attempt there.
Good inside leg kick. Trying to get a single. Oh, and down.
Nice right hand lands for Kailin Curran. The ground strikes continue to pile up.
Excellent movement on the ground here. Constantly moving, constantly staying busy.
Oh, sage work from the bottom here as she tags her with the punch. Punch there by Curran.
Landing some good punches from this
and
position.
That's gonna do it.
She's out. Oh! Big ground and pound KO.
Yes, Joe, just outstanding ground and pound for her to finish her opponent tonight. She was throwing one big shot after the next, not just looking to score, but actually looking to end the fight.
And here's the end of the fight. Let's see it here again. Great angle here. Crank right on the jaw.
And there she is after the huge knockout here tonight. What a moment for this fighter. You can't help but feel good for her here tonight. The official decision is in. Here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Eve Levine has called a stop to this contest. At 2 minutes, 11 seconds of round number three. Declaring the winner by knockout, Kailin Curran.
Well, she's got all the tools, Joe, and she certainly put them to good use tonight as she gets the win and gets so with style points by way of the knockout. No judges needed for this one, and you can be sure her bankroll is going to be fatter on Monday morning. She'll probably get a bonus. At the very least, though, the celebration is on. You see there with her coaches and her teammates.
I'm Megan O'Leary, and this is your UFC Minute. This weekend, we brace for a crucial matchup, which is expected to shake up an entire division. To get into position for a world title shot, this fighter has fought tooth and nail against the best the women's strawweight division has to offer. And while getting into a number one contender's match is sweet enough, if this fighter beats her heated rival to earn that shot at the belt, the victory would be even more satisfying. That's it for today. Stay tuned for your next UFC Minute, and I'll see you at the fights.
All right, coming up next, a women's strawweight matchup between Jessica Andrade and Kailin Curran. All right, here she is, ladies and gentlemen, making her way to the octagon, so the wait is nearly over for this rivalry matchup here tonight. These fighters do not like each other. That is not breaking news. If you'd followed this fight during fight week, the bad blood getting up in each other's faces at the weigh-in, we'll see who emerges in this rivalry matchup here tonight.
This woman has frightening knockout power. Absolutely thunderous power behind both her punches and her kicks. She is a real threat to knock anyone out in this division.
All right, so here she is back making the walk here tonight. Her takedowns certainly are the best in this division. So explosive. Her technique is just outstanding. And Joe, there's no telegraph. Even when the opponent has prepared and seemingly feels like they know what's coming, she will shoot from far out, still get in on those legs, and still get you exactly where you don't want to be, fighting off of your back. As scary a takedown artist as we have in this women's division.
This girl has outstanding defense and very good blocking technique. It's so difficult to hit her cleanly. It is a big advantage for her, and she has so much confidence in her defense because of that.
Our tale of the tape for this strawweight fight. Both fighters are now 30 years old, with similar height and some differences in reach. Here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is three rounds in the UFC strawweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, a kickboxer holding a professional record of 13 wins, 2 losses. She stands 5 feet 4 inches tall, weighing in at 115 pounds. Fighting out of Eva Beach, Hawaii, Kailin Curran. And now introducing her opponent, fighting out of the red corner, a Muay Thai kickboxer holding a professional record of 33 wins, 12 losses. She stands 5 feet 3 inches tall, weigh in at 115 pounds. Fighting out of Rio de Janeiro, Brazil, Jessica Batista Andrade. And when the action begins, our referee in charge, Dan Mergliotta.
Dan Mergliotta, your referee.
You ready? You ready?
Here we go. All right, so here we go with the oh!
Body kick, look at that.
Oh, wow. Huge right hand. Oh, big left. How about that shin?
Huge uppercut misses.
Andrade gets the early takedown.
Yeah.
She's working from half guard. And now she's got full mount.
She's going for the arm bar here.
She's got that arm bar locked up. It's very close here. Break the grip. That was a deep arm bar, but a beautiful escape. She's working from side control. Let's go.
Just over 3 minutes to go.
Big shot to the head. She's hurt. She is stunned. This could be it. Nice flying knee attempt there.
Oh, she landed a huge knee to the head.
Oh, another one. Oh! That's a big punch from the clinch. Vicious, vicious punch combinations here. Nice takedown.
Just over 2 minutes to go in what has been a furious round one.
Vicious shots to the body.
Trying to stay heavy here as best she can.
Trying to spin to the back. Both hooks it. She establishes full mount. She's looking to set up an arm bar. That arm looks locked up tight.
Nicely done.
So just before the round ends, she lands a huge shot, drops her opponent. The referee wisely jumps in to stop the action right there. And maybe her opponent was looking forward to that next round and didn't think that she was really going to go for it. She went for it and gets the biggest win of her UFC career here tonight.
Look at this. Boom! Right on the money.
And there she is after the huge knockout here tonight. What a moment for this fighter. You can't help but feel good for her here tonight. Back inside the octagon once again, here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Mergliotta has called a stop to this contest at 4 minutes, 55 seconds of the very first round. Declaring the winner by knockout, Kailin Curran.
So the rivalry matchup goes her way here tonight. She can finally exhale. You see her celebrating with her coaches and her teammates. She wanted this one in the worst way, and she gets it. Nice way to take advantage of the spotlight here tonight. All right, coming up next, it is a most anticipated women's strawweight matchup between Kailin Curran and Randa Quiet Storm Marcos. Well, what a story here. Randa Quiet Storm Marcos, born in Baghdad, Iraq, under heavy fire really every step of the way, was able to escape with her mother and her siblings. And what a story it is that she's gone on to UFC strawweight contention. In this 115-pound division, she is definitely Canada's best hope for UFC glory. Coming off a big win over the former champion Carla Esparza, Randa Quiet Storm Marcos is back tonight.
This girl has amazing top control. She is so good at keeping the fight on the ground. Once she gets you there, it is very rare that you see her lose positions. She's just so strong in the top position.
Well, there is no denying this woman's technique when it comes to her kicking game,
but it's the speed that I think really jumps off the film for me. She doesn't telegraph a damn thing, gets her foot to the target blindingly fast. Fighters don't even see it coming. Certainly her opponent has to be wary of the lightning fast kicks coming her way tonight.
This girl is a very high level striker. Unpredictable angles. She will throw punches and kicks with vicious intention. Excellent hand and foot speed. Very good striker and very good takedown defense as well. And she will need that to try to keep this fight on the feet.
Our tale of the tape for this strawweight fight. So a more than 5-year gap between these two fighters when it comes to the age, with the same height and a similar reach. Now here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is 3 rounds in the UFC strawweight division. It's your receivers fighting out of the corner. A mixed martial artist holding a professional record of 12 wins, 8 losses, and 1 draw. She stands 5 feet 4 inches tall, weighing in at 115 pounds. Ronda Quiet Storm Marcos. And now introducing her opponent, fighting out of the red corner. This woman is a kickboxer holding a professional record of 14 wins, 2 losses. She stands 5 feet 4 inches tall, weighing in at 115 pounds. Fighting out of Eva Beach, Hawaii, Kailin Curran. And when the action begins, our referee in charge, Dan Mergliotta.
Dan Mergliotta.
You ready? You ready?
Well, the Octagon has touched down here at United Center in Chicago, Illinois. Seemingly an annual stop for the MMA leader here in the Windy City. Great to have you with us, as always, as we get underway. All right, here she is, Ronda Quiet Storm Marcos, outstanding Canadian strawweight, and one who is very hard to put away. She has only been finished once. She has more stoppage wins to her credit. So Ronda Marcos, back at it tonight. We'll see if she can get off to a good start. Trying to stay heavy here as best she can. All right, first round is underway. Let's see how long it takes her to find her range with those vaunted, powerful overhand punches. Obviously, it's a big part of her repertoire, and more often than not, the UFC, even when opponents have known it has been coming, they have been unable to stop it. Just out of range with that right hand. Gets the single leg takedown.
First. Excellent movement on the ground here. Constantly moving, constantly staying busy. Hard kick to the head.
Oh, big left hook there.
Oh.
And there comes the separation now.
Beautiful left hand.
Huge left hand.
Oh, very nice.
Head kick.
Excellent movement here on the ground. She's in half guard now. Lands a nice left.
Well, she got kicked flush to the body there, Joe, right underneath her elbow, right underneath that guard. But it almost looks as though she's moving right into it. So until she makes the adjustments, you can figure her opponent is going to continue to attack that area.
Excellent posture.
Oh, posture's up. It delivers a big ground and pound strike to the head. Nicely done there by Kailin Curran.
Excellent punch.
Marcos gets caught with that punch. The ground strike's starting to pile up.
She's out.
And that's going to do it.
Brutal ground and pound for the KO.
Yes, Joe, just outstanding ground and pound for her to finish her opponent tonight. She was throwing one big shot after the next, not just looking to score, but actually looking to end the fight.
And here's the end. We can see it one more time from a different angle. Ground and pound at its finest, and that is the shot that ends this fight. Here we see it again. Lands perfectly, and that's the end.
And there she is after the huge knockout here tonight. What a moment for this fighter. You can't help but feel good for her here tonight. We get the official decision from Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Mergliotta has called a stop to this contest at 4:10 of the very first round. Declaring the winner by knockout, Kailin Curran!
Well, there are few greater highs in all of professional sports than to have your hand raised inside that octagon, but she took it a step further tonight. Massive knockout victory. No TKO here. This was a flush KO. She's probably getting some bonus money. One thing I can guarantee.
Hey everyone, I'm Megan O'Leary, and here's what you need to know for your UFC Minute. It's an old fight game adage that fans love nothing more than a knockout. If that's the case, then they will love this women's strawweight banger, who was celebrated today for delivering the most knockouts in UFC history. A record achieved thanks to her devastating prowess in the octagon with her fists, feet, elbows, and knees. That's it for today. Stay tuned for your next UFC Minute, and I'll see you at the fight. Hey everyone, I'm Megan O'Leary, and here's what you need to know for your UFC Minute. There comes a point in almost every fighter's career when what got them to the big dance just isn't enough anymore. That was the case this week when it was announced that the up-and-coming women's strawweight competitor will change gyms in order to work on her jiu-jitsu game on a more consistent basis. That's it for today. Stay tuned for your next UFC Minute, and I'll see you at the fights.
All right, coming up next, yes, a women's strawweight matchup between Kailin Curran and Tisha Tiny Tornado Torres. You know, it's one thing to take your opponent down. It's another thing to keep them there and control them on the ground. She knows exactly how to do it, and that's what really has led to a lot of her mixed martial arts success. Get the takedown, control her on the ground, and sap their willpower in the gas tank from there. You better stop the shot against this young woman tonight, because if you don't, problems.
This girl has a ridiculous chin. You never see her get hurt. You never see her get knocked down. She's one of the best chins in the business. And because of that, she has extreme confidence in striking exchanges.
For a long time, many believed she was one of the best 115-pounders in the world, and now she is one fight away from a shot at the strawweight title. This is a title eliminator tonight. It has been billed as such. UFC President Dana White is on board. She wins tonight. She will be next for the strawweight champion of the world.
This girl has ridiculously impressive, lightning-fast hand speed. It is one of her best qualities and one of the most terrifying things that you can face inside the octagon. When someone is faster than you, it is such a huge advantage.
Our tale of the tape for this strawweight fight. So these fighters relatively close in age, just a year apart. Some differences in height and reach. Here's Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this fight is three rounds of the UFC strawweight division. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, a kickboxer holding a professional record of 25 wins, 9 losses. She stands 5'1" tall, weighing in at 115 pounds, fighting out of Coconut Creek, Florida, USA, Tisha the Tiny Tornado Torres. And now introducing her opponent, fighting out of the red corner, kickboxer, holding a professional record of 15 wins, 2 losses. She stands 5'4" tall, weighing in at 115 pounds, fighting out of Inner Beach, Hawaii, Kailin Curran. And when the action begins, our referee in charge, Herb Dean.
Herb Dean, our referee for this one. Well, thanks for showing up on time as we get underway here tonight at the world-famous O2 Arena in London, England. All right, so here we go, early round one. You know how deep the this UFC strawweight division is, but if she wins this fight tonight, her first number one contender fight, she is guaranteed a shot at the UFC strawweight championship. She is...
Oh! This could be it!
Oh!
Oh, look at this! Who saw that coming?
Oh, straight right!
Huge uppercut misses.
Switching stances here. How about that shin? Well, she continues to leave that head open, and she paid for it there. She's almost moving into the strike. She hasn't changed up her tempo, but she continues to keep her head on that center line. We'll see if she can make the proper adjustments here. Torres gets tagged by the head kick there. Not sure how many more of those she can absorb if she wants to stay in this fight.
Really? Oh, jumping knee! That's a big hook.
Under 3 minutes now to go in the round. Oh, big left hook there. Really good body kick. Oh!
Oh! This could be it right here. Big shots!
Oh! The jab followed by the right hand.
Just missed with that huge kick.
That one hurt. And there's a single attempt.
And she's got her down.
Curran gets caught with that punch.
Wow. That left high kick came out of nowhere.
Damaging punch lands for her there.
Wow! This could be it!
No!
She's stunned! She's out!
Wow! Wow!
A huge kick for the knockout victory.
Oh, absolutely, Joe. A tremendous kick to end the fight here tonight. She caught her opponent absolutely flush. Full force, even better on the extension, and there was no chance for her to stay in the fight after that. You can make the argument that as soon as she lifted that foot up from the canvas, if she landed, that was going to be goodnight. And indeed it was.
Here it is from a different angle. Take a look at this from a different angle. Bang.
And there she is after the massive knockout. That is one they will be talking about for quite some time. Bruce Buffer has the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Herb Dean has called a stop to this contest at 3 minutes, 53 seconds of the very first round. Declaring the winner by knockout, Kailin Curran.
Well, she's got all the tools, Joe, and she certainly put them to good use tonight as she gets the win and gets so with style points by way of the knockout. No judges needed for this one, and you can be sure her bankroll is going to be fatter on Monday morning. She'll probably get a bonus. At the very least, though, the celebration is on.
Fighters fight for many different reasons. Some do it for the fame. Others do it for the money. Eventually, all of that fades away. Yet going down in the history books as a UFC champion is something no one can ever take. It's proof that for a moment in time, out of all the fighters in your weight class, you were the best in the world. It's the culmination of all your hard work, the fulfillment of a dream. Tonight is your chance to take that gold belt and hear Bruce Buffer say, and new. That kind of glory lasts forever.
It is a women's strawweight matchup between Joanna Jedrzejczyk and Kailin Curran.
Strawweight.
so much talent in this UFC strawweight division, but few contenders have had a rise as expeditious as this young woman tonight. She has paid her dues, she has worked her way up the ranks rather quickly, and now she is on the brink of being the UFC strawweight champion. We'll see how her style matches up tonight, Joe Rogan.
As she makes her way to the octagon right now, her preparation has been perfect. She is in fantastic shape, she is focused, she is motivated, and she believes she will leave this cage tonight as the new champion of the world.
So much depth now at 115 pounds, but they're all still chasing her. Yeah, they are, the undisputed UFC strawweight champion. And she's got the confidence that belies a champion. As you see her make this walk here tonight, she won the belt with flying colors, defended it with style points, and that's the same goal here tonight. She really is a fighter that maintains a calm demeanor, takes it fight by fight. She has aspirations to be the greatest of all time. She is well on her way.
The champion is making her way to the cage right now. Her preparation for this title bout has been absolutely according to plan. She is focused, she is in great shape, motivated, and determined to step in here and put on a championship-level performance and retain her title.
Our tale of the tape for this strawweight championship fight. 4 years, the difference in age between these two fighters, with similar height and the same reach. We send it inside the octagon. Bruce Buff.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge of the octagon, Dan Mergliotta. And now, this is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the T-Mobile Arena in Las Vegas, it's time! 5 rounds for the undisputed UFC strawweight championship of the world. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This woman is a kickboxer holding a professional record of 16 wins, 2 losses. She stands 5'4" tall, weighing in at 115 pounds. Fighting out of Eva Beach, Hawaii, introducing the challenger, Kailin Curran. And now, introducing the champion, fighting out of the red corner. This woman is a Muay Thai kickboxer, holding a professional record of 18 wins, 3 losses. She stands 5'6" tall, weighing in at 115 pounds. Fighting out of Austin, Poland, presenting the reigning, defending, undisputed UFC strawweight champion of the world, Joanna Jedrzejczyk.
All right, this is for the UFC championship. I want you to obey my commands at all times, protect yourself at all times, and a nice, clean, safe fight. Touch gloves, back your corners, come out fighting.
This has been one of the most highly anticipated matchups for a long time. And ladies and gentlemen, strap yourselves in, because it's about to go down right now.
Dateline, Las Vegas, Nevada. Oh! Superman punch. She's
out. Oh! She's out.
Can you believe it?
Beautiful strike here to end the fight early in the first.
Yeah, Joe, outstanding technique by her to land that shot and finish the fight here in the first round. Sometimes when you catch a fighter cold before she's had a chance to get going in the fight, it can have a more pronounced effect. That is certainly the case in this fight here tonight. What a result, what a knockout.
Let's see it again. Tremendous force, and that's a wrap. Check it out here. Boom.
Well, the stakes were championship, and man, did that woman get the job done here tonight. The UFC Women's Strawweight Champion taking home the belt with a massive knockout win tonight.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Mergliotta has called a stop to this contest at 38 seconds of the very first round, declaring the winner by knockout and new.
So congratulations are in order to the new UFC champion. And what is it going to take to dethrone this new champion? She was absolutely on point here tonight. Big title opportunity. She took full advantage. Can't wait to see how her championship reign plays out.
Hey, everyone. I'm Megan O'Leary, and it's time for your UFC Minute. The MMA world is buzzing about that incredible performance this past weekend in the main event. Last weekend at T-Mobile Arena in Las Vegas, Nevada, it was a night to remember for the mixed martial artist whose story has captured the imagination of fans around the globe as she fought the fight of her life when it mattered the most. When the dust settled, Bruce Buffer said, and knew. And she was crowned UFC Women's Strawweight Champion of the World thanks to a memorable referee stoppage. That's it for today. Stay tuned for your next UFC Minute, and I'll see you at the fights.